Hi, and welcome to Shopping East Tennessee. I'm Kim Palo, and today I am with Laura Martz again here at Relics Vintage Decor, right? Antiques and Vintage Decor. Yes, you have wonderful pieces. Your shop looks absolutely beautiful, and thank you for having us out here today.
I appreciate you coming. It's an honor to be on the show.
Well, great. Well, all right, Laura, let's talk a little bit about where you are and what you do. You know the drill. We've done this before together. So let's talk a little bit about Relics, about how long you've been in business and where you're located. And just tell us a little bit about, you know, whet the people's interest about who you are and what you've got out here.
Relics has been in business for a little over 4 years ago. Mm-hmm. We're located at 2270 Candies Lane. That's where the T&D Christian Bookstore used to be, or across from the old Rolling Hills Golf Course, down Candies Lane. I've been buying antiques for 30 years and selling for about 12.
And you do a great job. You look for really quality pieces, and you have an eclectic collection here, a little bit of everything out for any collector. But you are not the Antiques Roadshow. You do not do appraisals. That's right.
That's right. I do buy a lot from people here in the community, but I'm not a certified appraiser, so I am interested in looking at buying things from people. Can look it up while you're here and see if it's something that you want to sell, but I don't do appraisals so much.
And that's one thing that you've been seeing a lot out there right now, is there's a lot of businesses that are doing appraisals that really shouldn't be doing those, and you may not would get what it's really worth. And what's great about Laura is that she's here. If you've got an antique or a vintage piece that she purchases from you and she's going to resell, you can come back in and see it in this shop and see what that she's giving you a fair price for it when she's reselling. Of course, she's got to make some money, but she's going to give you a fair price, so that's a great thing about that. Now, what do people need to do? Would they just bring it in? Would you rather them make an appointment, or can they just stop by?
They can stop by. You do need to call and make sure I'm here. We're open 7 days a week, 10 to 6 Monday through Saturday, and 1 to 4 on Sundays, but I don't work every day. I do take a little bit of time off to be with family. So do call first. A lot of people bring small items in. If you need me to come see furniture, we can make an appointment to do that, and that's whenever I'm usually off. When I'm off, I'm out seeing estates and buying from people. Or send pictures. Just give me a call at 791-1951.
Right, and we'll
790-1951.
Yeah. I understand. We'll put that up on the screen. Jennifer, we'll put that up there for so that you'll have the phone number to give Laura a call. But yes, she will look at your pieces and tell you if you've got something of value, and then she may be interested in purchasing it and then reselling. Now, she does have a lot of great pieces. Let's talk about some of the vintage pieces and the antiques that you have in here. Right now, we're sitting in a couple of chairs that have got a kind of neat story to them. Is that I'm in the manly chair today, and so I am in the larger chair. I have a higher prestige, but Laura is sitting in the women's chair. It's the ladies' chair.
Right.
Tell us a little bit about them.
These chairs date from the late 1800s. They're stuffed with straw, and it's falling through on the bottom a little bit. But these are great chairs. They sit comfortably, and they're less than $100 a piece. And I think that's a misconception a lot of people have about antiques, is they think an antique store is going to be full of stuffy, dirty old glassware and expensive furniture, and that's just not the case. We have a store full of really nice chests, dressers, tables and chairs, and most all furniture in this store is going to be under $500. And it'll be made out of solid wood, and it's made to last another 100 years.
Yes, I saw a beautiful roll top desk over there, and I was very surprised at the price on it. I thought, no kidding. And she does have beautiful, now she does have the collector's glass. You have a lot of glassware in here that is beautiful. But then you've got some contemporary pieces that I've seen around here that are beautiful, that just kind of fit in, and they make for a nice conversation piece and just an eclectic look.
They do. I try to buy items that are unique and really can work in a lot of different decorating styles. I have mid-century modern, Victorian, eclectic, just anything unusual, wall art, but mostly from 1960s and older. I have books in here that date from the 1760s up through items through the 1960s. So you're covering about 300 years of items, and you may find a thing or two in here that's not antique, but it better be good looking or I don't want it in the store.
And it is good looking. She has good taste. That's one thing I can say for Laura, is that she has great taste. And when you walk through her shop, you are going to see so many things. And I mean, even Jennifer and I were both walking through a while ago, and there was some peacock things back there. And we're like, oh, look at the peacocks. And it was just really good looking. Also, I saw over here a journal that was started in January, and it was the actual like day timer from 1949. And I was like, how did that survive? I mean, I was like, you know, my luck, I'll pick it up and I'll tear the top page off.
Well, that's why I liked it. It tells a story. That's what's so wonderful about antique and vintage items, is most all of it's made in America, or at least in Europe. It's just a great way to accent your house. It's not made in China last week, and the quality is just wonderful.
It is, and there are so many different styles. And she also has jewelry. I mean, there's just a little bit of everything. You could spend an afternoon in this store, and I encourage you to do that, especially now that the weather's turned so nice and it's starting to get fall. This is a great place to spend your weekend, to come out here and just take a while, because it takes a while to go through the store. We have looked through, and every time I come, Laura, there's just new things that you always have, something new and something special, and you can just get lost and just take your time and spend a lot of time in here. Now, you started 4 years ago, and you're over on Candy's Lane, and you're open 7 days. What are your hours, your actual hours?
I am open Monday through Saturday from 10 to 6 and 1 to 4 on Sundays.
Oh, well, those are good. And those are good hours. Those are shopping hours. Those are good shopping hours to do that. And you have a website and you Facebook as well, so you can follow Laura on that, and it's Relics.
RelicStore.com is my website, but it's easier, and I keep more up to date on Facebook. You can find Relics Antiques Cleveland, Tennessee on Facebook, and I post a lot of pictures and try to keep you up to date when I've come back with a big load from Ohio or bought a big estate.
And that's how Laura does purchase. She goes on traveling trips, and she goes all across the country. Tell us a little bit what it entails to actually come back with the great stuff, how you get this great stuff in here.
Usually I drive about 1,000 miles round trip, wow, load the trailer, load the van, and look for just unique items that tell a story.
Well, see, you could be one of those American pickers, aren't you? She's an American picker. Maybe we could take a ride with her sometime. That would be fun. So tell us about some of the special items that you have in the store right now that you've just come back, you know, some of the new stuff that you have that you'd like for people to come and take a look at. Some of the classic, well, like these chairs here. And now, does this ottoman go with it, or just happen to match?
It's separate. It's just separate. And not particularly old. It just looked good with it. As you can see right behind us, there's a beautiful collection of late 1800s ironstone. I have mid 1800s majolica, beautiful glassware, Steuben, Kralik, Lotz, Dom Nancy from the early 20th century. But we also have antique books, antique cameras, jewelry, great wall art, and I love the old early 1900s toys. They're just beautiful and add a lot of wall character with the carob boards. Just anything unusual and unique. I've got items that range anywhere from $2 and $3 that are 100 years old up to $2,500 pieces of glass that are very highly collectible. So there's just so much to see in here, and many things that you just won't see anywhere around this part of the country. When I bring it in from the north or the south, it's unusual items.
Well, and that's what we want to stress so much to you, is what a different store this is and how much character that it has. I guess that you could, the store truly does have its own character, and it has such a great feel about it and so many different items that anyone, any collector or anyone that just wants a different piece, a conversational piece, or just to give something in your home that special pop, a special area, this is the place to come and look. And you're not going to spend a whole lot of money, and you're going to get a quality item. That's the one thing about Relics, is that she has quality, and she has very unique looking and feeling stuff. She has all kinds of stuff. She's got linens, you've got some textiles, I saw some tapestries back there, you've got just about everything.
Linens, textiles, vintage clothing, hats, antique and vintage purses, wall art, just anything, if it's odd and unusual, I want it in my store.
That's right. Or she wants it in her house. And sometimes she's not in the mood to sell something, so you have to catch her just right. We had some customers that were in here that caught her just right while ago, caught her in a good mood, and she was willing to sell something she hadn't been willing to sell before. So she has some specials. I guess you kind of get attached to some pieces and you just don't want to let them go.
I do. Whenever I come across something really unusual, it's sometimes I just want to love on it and enjoy it for a while and share it with my customers before I sell it, and then it's ready to go. I'm ready to let go of it.
that happens with everybody, with certain things that you have that you're willing one day to let it all go, and the next day it's like, you know, it's the most precious thing in the whole world. Well, Laura, let's talk about just a little, wrap up a little bit. Your Facebook is?
Relics Antiques, Cleveland, Tennessee. You can find me on Facebook or on relicsstore.com is my blog site.
The link, I think, is there,
yes,
also to go to.
Up.
Right, you can link up. She's very easy to find. She's right off the interstate. You're going to come down just right across at the light there where you go up to Mountain View Inn, right up there. You're going to go, instead of going up the hill, you're going to come down the hill right past the skating rink down there. You're going to come down Candy's Lane, and she's down on the right. It's a great location. It's a great store. You can get your easy in and easy out, no problems whatsoever to do that. And you want to remember that Relics is a great place for any type of conversation piece, any quality piece. She's got lots of porcelain, she's got stone. I've seen the different things that you have with the marble tops. You've got wood, you've got just about any texture that you want.
We do. We cover mid-century modern, Victorian, shabby chic, primitives. We really do cover a lot of variety in this.
Now, what's the difference between the shabby chic, okay, and primitive? Primitive is
much older.
Much older.
Much older, and usually in natural wood. The shabby chic is cottage style pieces, maybe French cottage or painted pieces, a little bit worn. Just got that soft look, usually in whites and off-whites are what I term as shabby chic.
Okay.
Or
that's
shabby cottage.
A shabby cottage.
Cottage. Yeah.
Well, I've got, mine may not be a shabby cottage.
Shabby cottage.
Cottage to go in. But there's something for everyone at Relics. And Laura will look at your pieces. I mean, she's not a certified appraisal, but she does look. She has the books. She knows the websites to go to look up stuff. She's a woman of integrity. She likes quality pieces. She will give you a fair price. Now, guys, she's got to make some money. She's not doing this just to be kind, even though she is kind.
You have to make a little bit of money to pay the rent.
Right, you have to make some money, but she would be interested in looking at your pieces. Anything that you would like to maybe possibly sell that she could put on the floor here. And like we said, she's here. So you're going to be able, it's not just a fly-by-night that's going to come through and give you a price for something and you don't know if you got a good price or not for it. She's going to be here and you'll be able to see it on the floor and know that that she's giving you a fair and good price. So you want to come out and see her. She is open 7 days a week, so you can bring your things out or just come and spend some time in the store. It's a great place to spend an afternoon and to just look around, because you really can get involved and look at everything from jewelry to knickknacks to all wall art, everything you could possibly want. Laura, thank you for having us out. We enjoy every time that we come to see you, and we love your store.
Appreciate that. Thanks for coming.
All right. I'm Kim Palo with Laura at Relics, and for Shopping East Tennessee, I'm Kim Palo.